So we are finally almost to the end, na tutasoma very interesting part ambayo ni binary star system. So tumekuwa tukiona kwamba kuna two bodies ambazo one is almost stationary, okay? Like one of the our focus ni kwamba suppose we having the sun and the earth is going around, okay, around it, or we having the earth and the planet is going around it. So to complicate things further to binary star system. So actually what is happening in a binary star system is that we are having two bodies, okay, of which they are revolving about, not about the center of one of the bodies, but are about the center of mass, okay? So we have seen cases where this is the sun, the earth is going around about, okay, the center of the sun, and all the earth in the satellite is going around above the center of the earth. But now we are having two bodies of which they are going around the center of mass. So suppose we are having this as body two and this as body one. So we expected this could be going, okay, around body two, or this body two could be going around body one, but they are going around this center of mass. Okay, so the first thing we should know is that we are having a body with mass one, okay, and mass two. So if this is the center of mass, the distance from the body one to the center of mass, let us call it to be R1, and the distance from the body two to the center of mass, call it R2. So what is usually happening is that the center of mass usually is closer to the body with more weight or more mass, and this is guided by the following formula: M1 times X1 is equal to M2 times X2. So this basically means the more the mass, the less the distance, because once they are a product, it means if you increase the other, you should decrease the other, so that to maintain a specific value. So the more the mass, the shorter the distance. The more the closer is the center of mass towards that body. So this is the formula that guides that. And X1 plus X2 is the distance X, where X is the distance between the two bodies. What I mean is that X1 plus X2 is, we can call it R, and this R is the distance between body center of mass 1 to center of mass 2. So you can see these bodies are revolving around the center of mass. That's why this mass is going around there with the radius R1, and mass 2 is going around there around the center of mass with the distance from the center as R2. So this is what is happening. So here we are having two forces taking part into play. Be very, very careful. Listen very, very carefully. In the previous, tulichokuwa tunasoma mwanzo kwenye satellites, kwenye sun na vitu vyote, tulikuwa tunasema centripetal force is equal to gravitational force. Okay? Ambapo tulikuwa tunasema centripetal force mv squared over r ni sawa sawa na, okay, we can call this r plus h whatsoever, ni sawa sawa na g, mass ambayo iko kwenye center of the motion, mass ya this body ambayo ina hii centripetal force, divided by r plus h squared. Okay, so this is what we are using, that distance tunayoongelea huku ndo distance tunayoongelea huku, but here it is different. Okay, here we are having centripetal force as usual given by mv squared over r, but remember circular motion tukiongelea kwa mfano kwa body 1 ni hii hapa. Okay, circular motion ni hii hapa, about distance of the radius of the sac on Yara 1 and not the total distance between the bodies. You see the difference? Here, the distance was between the two bodies, from the center of one body to the center of the other body. But here, we are talking of the distance of the radius of the sac, of which the distance is from the center of the body to the center of the mass, okay, which is Ara 1. Okay, so this is for V1 and for mass 1. Okay, yes. So the gravitational force, now this is very interesting. The gravitational force, however, is between the two bodies. Okay, because according to law of gravitation, it's saying the product of two masses, that the gravitational force is equal to the product of two masses, is directly proportional to the product of two masses, and inverse proportional to the distance between them squared, of which distance between them now is R squared, okay, with the big G. So the gravitational force distance to know to me, the R squared, which is the total distance between the two bodies. And for the centripetal force is the radius of the cycle, of which the radius is from the center of the body to the center of mass. So you have these two sides, but with different distances. This is something that is very special with the binary star system, and it is because they are revolving about the center of the cycle, the center of mass, of which is given by that. You can find it by using that. So you should first know this, and you should second know this concept. And therefore, for body 1, okay, if we cancel M1 and M1, so takwana V1 squared over R. So V1 squared over R, it means mass 1, na cancel mass huku na mass kule. Kwa mass 1 na mass 1 inakufa. Kwa unabaki na G, M2, divide by the total distance, R1 plus R2 squared. Okay? Kwa V1 squared divided by R1, ni sawa sawa na G times M2 over the total distance, R1 plus R2. So it is the same for V2 squared over R2, is asa na GM1 over R1 plus R2 squared. So this is also true for all other parameters. So second, if tutakacho derive hapa, andika hapo angular velocity for bodies in a binary star system. So we know if we are having velocity as V1 squared, if we make it the subject, itakuwa ni GM2 over R, ambao tumesema R ni R1 plus R2, okay, times R1, ambao ndio ilikuwa. You see the difference? Yes. V1. And therefore, square root ya hii, square root ya hii, tutakuwa na V1 is equal to square root ya GM2 R1 over R. And therefore, from here, this is the linear velocity, okay, the velocity, you can call it orbital velocity or the critical velocity, just like the previous. So here we know that V ni sawa sawa na WR, okay, V ni sawa sawa na WR. Therefore, the question is, which R are we talking about? So remember, the circular motion that we are talking about here, kumbuka, yani centripetal force ilikuwa inatumia distance from the body to the center of the mass, okay, mass, center of mass, and not center of the second body, center of mass. So hata tunavyoongelea angular velocity, tunavyoongelea centripetal acceleration, whatever, the distance that we talk here is the distance of the circle, the circular motion, and not the total distance for this case. You see, configuration review, you can see the cycle is not about the center of another body, but the center of mass. So if we speak of V ni sawa na WR, it means if we speak of V1, ni sawa na W times R1. Similarly to V2, ni sawa na W times R2. So here, it means W ni sawa na 2 pi. So we have V1 ni sawa na 2 pi over T times R1. Therefore, time period sawa sana 2 pi r1 over v. V1, this is r, this is v1. So this is the time period 1. So similarly for time period 2, ni sawa 2 pi r2 over v2. So you know v1 or v2, for this case ikiwa v2, it means hapa kutakuwa na mass 1 na hapa kutakuwa na r2 na hapa chini ni total distance. So this is how we go about this question. Let us see some examples.